Hello friends, so welcome to the journey of Podophyllum. We will understand Podophyllum step by step. Although this remedy is, you don't have to actually understand necessarily as a journey, as a step by step process, because this Podophyllum person reaches out of any kind of remedies will make a person reach into Podophyllum in some or the other way. You know, there is a rubric in Podophyllum, delusion, unification with higher consciousness. So here the talk is about being conscious and reaching to unify oneself to higher consciousness. Now, what is higher consciousness? So that is why I took little time to explain this remedy, although when I have applied it, it has been a very smooth process for me, because these people, they are in content, they are in absolute content. You know, the ladies who have got very high qualifications as per their studies, they have done very good studies, they are highly qualified intellectual people, but they have not persevered their or they have not pursued their ambitions to the extent that normally such educated ladies do. They have given up on their studies very, very easily. They have given up on their career so very easily, you know, without raising their voice, without even objecting to the pressures of husband, of in-laws, or maybe expectation of their own parents. They have not done anything like that. They have just easily surrendered themselves for the love, for the harmony. There is harmony desire in Podophyllum. So Podophyllum is a very easygoing person who just gives in so easily and is ready to serve. It is there and cares full of business about, cares full of future about. So they think that how they can be more caring towards their own people, towards their own family, towards their own surrounding, and they are ready to serve to them. They are ready to just let go of their own wishes and desires in the most amicable manner. They are in affability. So affability is having those very easygoing relation with people without even showing them, or without even themselves feeling any strong grudges or any strong anger. Although they are there in ailments from anger suppressed, they feel the anger, but they are somewhere very much reasoning out to why they are not expressing, or what are the situations due to which it is not necessary or not required that I should express my anger. So when we talk about unifying with higher consciousness, nowadays the world is so materialistic that we are only craving and craving for a lot of things. You know, if we buy one dress, we want to, and if we see our neighbor or our sister or our friend having a better dress or a better outfit with a better variety range, so we want to buy something more. Then we have a handset, we buy a mobile, and we see, you know, this new mobile has come in the market, in the advertisement we saw that this is something very attractive. Then they want to, then we really generally want to go and grab it, or we have that desire, you know, that let's buy this. But Podophyllum, even though they have the desire, they will be in a mode where they can explain to themselves that it is not necessary. What is the purpose of buying this kind of mobile? So this is how they explain to themselves that is there, they will first think over. So there is a difference in Podophyllum's unifying with higher consciousness and the sense of maturity that other remedies hold. Okay, now there are remedies of precocity and there are remedies of egotism. So Podophyllum is someone who doesn't hold any kind of ego. he doesn't put himself ahead of others. He doesn't portray the importance of himself, that I have done this for you and I sacrificed my life for you, I have sacrificed my career for you and I did this for you and I did that for you. No, podophyllum is just beyond all this. Is not beyond, it podophyllum is higher than all this. It has just outgrown himself of projecting his own importance, of complaining about people. Podophyllum has outgrown himself of holding others responsible for their sadness, for their problems, for their issues of life. They have just come out of all this and they have unified with higher consciousness in a way where they can understand the situation in a very clear manner, where they can understand that this life is what I feel. And what I am all about is my life is all about. So higher consciousness, you know, there are 6 states of consciousness. So if you just go through some articles or any book, if you have the levels of consciousness, you will understand that first we think, you know, that I am the doer and everything is happening because of me. Then we start putting blame on others. Then we feel that whatever I am suffering today in my life is because of him, because of that person and this and that. You know, gradually we come out of all this as we mature, as we advance in our age, in our understanding of our issues. Then we understand, you know, how a person goes into spirituality. So podophyllum is a person who you will feel to be a more spiritual person, because they are very happy people and they don't feel bad about anybody's behavior around. They accept their behavior wholeheartedly and they feel that whatever they have done, whatever others have done, it is their outlook. They cannot change it. So better let it be, and they keep themselves at peace. Tranquility, reconcile to fate will be a rubric that will go through and through in this remedy till the end, you know, from the start till the end it goes. So podophyllum children, how they will be? They will be very cheerful, jovial and happy-go-lucky. Playful is something, you know, if you open the rubric playful, if you open the rubric positiveness, so podophyllum is the remedy which is of highest marks in these rubrics. So they are always positive, they are always playful, enthusiastic about life, you know, loquacity, changing quickly from one subject to another. They don't stand on problems and keep dwelling and keep complaining, nagging, no, nothing like that. Cheerful, loquacity, cheerful, exuberant, loquacity with hilarity, loquacity vivacious and love exalted. They have that love for others and it is in an exalted manner. To whom they are connected, to people around, to nature, to his own relatives, to children, to husband, they have so much love that they don't feel the necessity of getting angry to them. So I would just quote one small episode or personalities, how you can understand podophyllum. You know, the character of Ram, the character of Sita in Ramayana, how they are projected, how the way they hold themselves. They say that, you know, whatever we are doing it on the basis of dharma. You know, my father has told me that you go to forest for 14 years, you leave the Rajmahal, you leave the palace, you are not part of our palace and you will not get the kingdom in spite of being the eldest of the 4 brothers due to whatever reasons. So I am telling you how they adapt to the situation. What was the reaction of Ram and what is expected of any person in that situation? So as soon as his father told him that you cannot be the king of this kingdom, although the entire procession was there and all the arrangements were made, the way with that smile, he just accepted it. tranquility reconciled to fate. This is written in my fate, and I will just accept it with a peace of mind, with a smile on my face, with that contentment that this is the best thing that can happen to me in my life. I will go to the forest, I will meet the sages, and I will be among the saints, among the best of people. And this is how that acceptance comes, and they feel that, you know, whatever is coming to me in my life is because I have given those signals out that I want to receive this kind of knowledge, I want to receive this kind of wisdom in my life, that in spite of being from such a high kingdom, I will be living in the forest. This is the humility, you know. Humility is that it's a combination. Humility is a combination of dignity, and at the same time, you know, you don't you are very intellectual, but you don't show that I am intellectual. You show that, you know, in spite of having all the knowledge, in spite of being the richest among the rich, but when my presentation is there, I don't carry that aura around me. Anybody can be very comfortable with me. That is the humility Ram carried all through when he was in the forest, when he met his Gurukul friend also in the forest, who was from a lower class, who was a poor person. Still, he just took him in his arms, and this is the way he carried himself all through in that journey. So this is how Podophyllum's acceptance is there, with the peace, with the smile, with that tranquility. The tranquility is something undisturbed peace. Nobody can disturb that peace, you know. It is inside you. Disturbance is outside you. So if you are at peace inside, nobody can enter inside and disturb you. So tranquility, this is the essence of Podophyllum, that inside only they are so much at peace with themselves. You know, if you are not at peace with yourself, then others can disturb you. But Podophyllum is at peace with himself, and therefore there was nothing outside that could really shatter Ram in any of the conditions, in any situations. So I'm not saying that he's through and through Podophyllum, but this is how Podophyllum personalities you will find in real life. That what is the necessity of having an Android mobile when I just have to make calls, so I can use a normal mobile also. What is the use of, you know, why should I wear those shiny jackets and blazers and put a hat and all, when, you know, I just have to cover my body. So this is the kind of talk they do. So then there is the similar rubrics, you know, beautiful things yearning for. This is the beauty of Podophyllum. They will just want to be delightful. Their yearning is for beauty. Their yearning is not for showy, you know, show off. It is not a show off at all. Something that can just give you a glorious face or something. It is not necessary that, you know, I have to put a lot of makeup and then only that beauty will be seen. So that is how Podophyllum thinks, that just be simplistic and be that glorious. So those people, when you meet them, you will feel very happy after meeting them, by their cheerful attitude, by the way they talk, by the way they just carry on the simple living, and yet that high thinking. So this is the funda of Podophyllum. So if you see ailments from honor wounded is also there. So in spite of the honor getting wounded, their reaction pattern won't be as we see in other remedies of egotism, as we see in other remedies who are carrying that dignity in them. Their reaction will be just with tranquility. Tranquility reconciled to fate at every step you will see in this remedy. They are very sensitive to reprimands, ailments from reprimands, ailments from death of loved ones, ailments from bad news, ailments from domination in children. Even though they get dominated, but their reaction, their adaptation is so peaceful, so charming, you know. Discrimination lack of, they don't discriminate in amongst people. So, talking about their very, very good qualities, you know, I can just go on and on about talking of Podophyllum. There is one rubric, firmness. What is firmness, you know? In spite of so many people who were telling Ram that you just don't go for Vanvas so easily, he was very firm. He never reacted badly to explain to people. He was just firm. He kept on repeating one sentence and people got convinced only with that one sentence again and again. So firmness has a strength of character, and Podophyllum does have a strength of character. We will do it in the next video also. Thank you so much. Do comment, like and subscribe. Thank you.